three conditions in which mother develop, may develop antibodies. Blood transfusion before marriage by blood from Rh person. Then if the mother negative and had blood transfusion before marriage, she is ready to develop either she developed antibodies or she is ready, sensitive to develop easily antibodies. Second, leakage of during pregnancy of small amount of fetal blood. Okay. Of fetal blood, Rh positive into maternal circulation, placenta, hemorrhage. Three, during delivery, some blood squeezed back to maternal blood. In one of these three conditions, the mother may develop antibodies. In this condition, one of the following hemolytic diseases may occur. First, erythroblastos fetalis, mild disease. Small amount of RBCs leak into mother circulation. Some mothers develop antibodies against the D antigen. These antibodies pass to fetal blood and cause mild hemolysis of the RBCs of the fetus. This newborn can be rescued by giving him Rh negative blood, but not from his mother, because in the mother there are antibodies. If we transfuse blood from the mother, then we can expose the child to more serious dangers of hemolysis and agglutination. Second, icterus gravis neonatorum, kernicterus, moderate disease. The infant is born at 10, jaundiced, or becomes so within 24 hours. There may be severe neurological lesions involving the basal ganglia in which the white pigments deposit. While the most severe is the hydrops fetalis, severe disease. The hemolysis is severe. Infant may die in uterus or may develop severe anemia, jaundice, and anemia, dies within few hours. And then these three diseases may occur because of the incompatibility of the blood groups. Fortunately, this disease can be prevented by giving an Rh negative mother human gamma globulin against Rh positive erythrocyte within 72 hours after she has delivered an Rh positive infant. These antibodies bind to the antigenic site on any Rh positive erythrocyte that might have entered the mother's blood during delivery and prevent them from inducing antibody synthesis by the mother. The administered antibodies are eventually catabolized. You may be wondering whether ABO incompatibilities are also cause hemolysis disease of the newborn. For example, a woman with type O blood has natural antibodies to both A and B antigen. If her fetus is type A or B, this theoretically should cause problem. Fortunately, it usually does not, partly because of the A and B antigen are not strongly expressed in fetal erythrocyte, and partly because the natural antibodies are of the IgM type, which do not readily cross the placenta. This is the compatible blood transfusion. You see, O can donate blood to all other blood groups and to himself or herself, because there are no antigens, but this blood contains antibodies. It can donate blood to all other blood groups. Therefore, this is called general donor. And AB, you see, this blood group contains both antigens, but no antibodies in the plasma. Therefore, can receive blood from the other, from all the other blood groups. Therefore, it's called general recipient. You see, when the O blood group donates to anyone of the other blood group, the antibodies present in the O blood group are diluted in the blood of the recipients. But this is not always general donor, because the patient cannot tolerate more than 2-3 bags. I mean cannot tolerate more than 1 liter blood or above little bit. Otherwise, for sure, agglutination occurs, because the antibodies, lot of antibodies, can be transfused in the other, into the blood of the other blood groups, and agglutination occurs. And then you see, general donor is not always general donor. General recipient is not general recipient. There is limitation for the blood transfusion from one group to another, unless the patient can receive blood from his blood group. And also there is limitation for this transfusion because of the other dangers. These are the indications of blood transfusion. First, to restore blood volume, such as in hemorrhage. Second, to provide red blood cells in anemia. Three, to increase blood coagulability in hemorrhagic diseases, such as hemophilia and purpura. Four, to replace infant's blood with Rh negative blood in erythroblast fetalis. Five, to supply antibodies to raise the general resistance of the body. Six, to provide white blood cells, such as leukemia. And last, seven, to supply plasma proteins in hyperproteinemia. You see, these are the indications of the blood transfusion. There are machines now separate the components of the blood. We can transfuse just RBCs, or just white blood cells, or just coagulation factors, or just antibodies, or just plasma. Complications of blood transfusion. The complications, either early or late. Early complications, hemolytic reactions, immediate or delayed, reactions due to infected blood, allergic reactions to white blood cells, platelets or proteins, circulatory overload, air embolism, citrate toxicity, hyperkalemia, and clotting abnormality after massive transfusion. But the late complications, transmission of diseases such as hepatitis, malaria, syphilis, and AIDS, or transfusional iron overload immune sensitization to a rhesus blood group. Just few points about the use of stored blood. When we take blood to store it in the blood bank, we have to do the following point. First, the blood should be tested, grouped, and cross-matched. Just have an idea about the cross-matched. Second, the anticoagulant used is ACD, acid citrate dextrose, It should be stored at temperature 4 Celsius degrees. And you have to take care, or you have to be careful if when the blood is transfused. First, if there is no time to permit for grouping and cross-matching, you have to donate the blood or Rh negative. In extreme emergencies, or Rh positive. Then this you have to take care about the above points. Blood transfusion is used usually for the donation of red blood cells, but not for platelets or white blood cells, because white blood cells, they have short half-life, as well as platelets. Even for the donation of white blood cells and platelets, you need fresh blood. Just for example, after 14 days at 4 degrees stored blood, the red blood cells treated show 80% survival 24 hours after transfusion. And thereafter, the survival cells are destroyed at the rate of about 1% per day. Stored blood is not suitable, as we said, for medium or conveying leukocytes, for transfusion of leukocytes or platelets. Brief idea about the blood groups and platelets. Let me give examples just to have an idea about the phenotype and genotype of the blood groups. This is the phenotype. A are Rh positive MN. And the mother or the wife, B, Rh negative, and N. This is the phenotype. Now we'll see the probable example of the probable genotypes. Then you see this is the phenotype, A, Rh positive, and N. This is the first probability. A, Rh, Rh, MN, because both are dominant. And AO, Rh, Rh, MN, or AA, Rh, Rh, MN, or AO, Rh, Rh, MN. While the mother, this is the phenotype, B, Rh negative. B, Rh negative, NN, and both dominant. Either B, B, Rh, NN, or B, O, Rh, NN. Just to have an idea about the genotype and phenotype in the human being, depending on the blood groups.